The biggest sin. Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. Wassalatu wassalamu ala khayril mursaleen. Assalamu alaikum, dear Muslims, and welcome back to Al Kabaer. Today's Kabira is one of the worst acts a human being could commit that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has mentioned it in His holy book. And the punishment was so severe because it was one of the worst ever. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is passing a message to us in the story of the Prophet Lut. From Surah Al-A'raf, we can read,
وَلُوطًا إِذْ قَالَ لِقَوْمِهِ أَتَأْتُونَ الْفَاحِشَةَ مَا سَبَقَكُمْ بِهَا مِنْ أَحَدٍ مِّنَ الْعَالَمِينَ إِنَّكُمْ لَتَأْتُونَ الرِّجَالَ شَهْوَةً مِّنْ دُونِ النِّسَاءِ بل أنتم قوم مسرفون وما كان جواب قومه إلا أن قالوا أخرجوهم من قريتكم إنهم أناس يتطهرون فأنجيناه وأهله إلا امرأته كانت من الغابرين وأمطرنا عليهم مطرا فانظر كيف كان عاقبة المجرمين.
And we had sent Lut when he said to his people, "Do you commit such immorality, as no one has preceded you with from among the worlds? Indeed, you approach men with desire instead of women. Rather, you are a transgressing people." But the answer of his people was only that they said, "Evict them from your city. Indeed, they are men who keep themselves pure." So we saved him and his family, except for his wife. She was of those who remained with the evildoers. And we rained upon them a rain of stones. Then see, how was the end of the criminals. Look at the severity of the punishment in Surah Hud. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says,
سافلها وأمطرنا عليها حجارة من سجيل منضود مسومة عند ربك وما هي من الظالمين ببعيد.
So when our command came, we made the highest part of the city its lowest, and rained upon them stones of layered hard clay, which were marked from your Lord, and Allah's punishment is not from the wrongdoers very afar. No other nation in history had such a kind of punishment except the people of Lut. A curse blinding their eyes, the whole city risen above the earth and cast upside down, burying people deep inside the earth, and lastly, throwing molten rocks over the city. It is very scary to imagine something like this.
Inna munziluna ala ahli hadhihi al-qaryati rijzan min as-samai bima kanu yafsuqun. وَلَقَدْ تَرَكْنَا مِنْهَا آيَةً بَيِّنَةً لِقَوْمٍ يَعْقِلُونَ.
Indeed, we will bring down on the people of the city a punishment from the sky because they have been defiantly disobedient. and we have certainly left of it a sign and clear evidence for a people who use reason. You can go and see the remains of the city of Sodom in the deepest area on earth, the Dead Sea. Sadly, with all the media and making same-sex marriage legal, some Muslims, especially the young, who have lack of iman and knowledge, are starting to think of and commit this crime. Some Muslim women feel that Islam's rules are very harsh on them, and after all the brainwashing of woman liberty, they now are preferring to live without a husband, and this pushes them to become lesbians. The punishment in Islam for those who commit this crime is very severe. It should be the same punishment Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala chose for the people of Lut. Look at this hadith. The Prophet ﷺ said, "من وجدتموه يعمل عمل قوم لوط فاقتلوا الفاعل والمفعول به." Whoever you find doing the action of the people of Lut, kill the one who does it and the one to whom it is done. Most scholars suggested that the punishment of gay people should be by stoning them after being cast from the highest point in town. Some said that stoning is enough. The Prophet, peace be upon him, said, "إن أخوف ما أخاف على أمتي عمل قوم لوط," that the thing that I most fear for my nation is the action of the people of Lut. And in the end, it looks like this awful Kabaer will be more and more accepted by the next Muslim generation. But many would ask, why is it so bad a thing? Many reasons. Firstly, and most importantly, when people commit this sin, they are changing the sin of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Secondly, it cultivates new deadly diseases as proven by science. Furthermore, there will be no reproduction, and if there is, it will be abnormal. It will lead relationships and ways of life astray, causing the downfall of the nation that accepted it. We should warn our children about this evil and teach them to be aware of it. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protect us and our children from all kabair and help us place taqwa in our heart and protect us from shaitan. Ameen. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.